Dang. I didn't even realize you packed all this. Okay.
Snack.
That's how you feel?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, please hit that subscribe button, also hit the notification bell so you won't miss a beep whenever I do post a new video. I know it's been a while, I've been gone a long time, but this is why. I'm currently 37 weeks pregnant, going on 38 weeks, so any day now. But today, I just want to show you guys what is in our hospital bag so that way it can go ahead and go to the car, to the trunk. If you hear that I'm out of breath while talking, it's because I'm pregnant and it's hard for me to talk and demonstrate things while I'm pregnant at the same time. So I'm gonna start with Junior's bag. This is his diaper bag. Set the focus. This is his diaper bag. It was gifted to us by my mommy for his baby shower. It's an Eddie Bauer bag. It's a pretty reputable company. Haven't heard any like bad reviews about Eddie Bauer. Yeah, I heard these last a pretty long time, so. We're gonna start with what's in his hospital bag first. I know people be like, oh, well, you don't have to take all this to the hospital for the baby or for you, but like, I'm really particular about my stuff, so I already know I'm gonna be particular about what my son is gonna be in. So I know at the hospital, from what I've been told, I'm a first time mom. It's my first child, by the way. I know at the hospital they provide you like with diapers, wipes, all that good stuff, baby soap and all that, blase. But I'm like real particular, like I said, about stuff that I use, so I'm particular about the stuff that he's gonna be using. And I'm not thinking in the hospital they're gonna be using like Johnson Johnson. I really don't want to use that, so we're not gonna use that. But the only thing that I already packed for him was his baby blanket, outfits, towels, and a pacifier. I believe that's it. Cause like I said, I'm particular about my stuff. So I'm particular about his stuff. So we can start with the towels first. My aunt, she is a nurse. She used to work in labor and delivery as a nurse, and she told me that the face towels that they use, well, the baby bath towels that they use at the hospital for the babies, are pretty rough. So I went ahead and packed just three of his, just to be on the safe side. I went ahead and packed three for him because I don't want anything rough touching him. This is the car seat cover. Was gifted to us at the baby shower as well. It's the car seat cover. For when he goes home. I have a hooded drying towel for him. It's so cute. Oh, this one's actually not hooded. I thought it was. Just a regular drying towel for him. Cute little elephants and things on it. Also, his baby blanket. I put a baby blanket in here for him, just so he can be more comfortable. There's an idea that I got from, I don't know if it was off of YouTube or if it was from this pregnancy Facebook group that I'm in, but I saw women packing like whenever they'll pack their diaper bag, whether it's, you know, to go deliver or to go somewhere if they're traveling or whatever, they would like put things in little Ziploc bags to make sure everything's organized. So that's what I did. I got two burping cloths in here. I'm not gonna take these out. They're just regular old burping cloths. And I have two bibs in here. Just two cute little bibs. You know, may not need any of that, but you know, I'd rather be safe than sorry. Now onto his little outfits. So, of course, I'm unsure of how big he's gonna be when he finally gets here. So I went ahead and put two newborn outfits in the bag and 2 0-to-3 month outfits in the bag. Because you just never know. But one thing that I thought was really, really cute, but we're gonna start with his newborn stuff. So, one outfit in here, one outfit in here. In each little baggie, I got socks, a hat, mittens, onesie, and like some little pants. So let's start with this one. This is a little hat. Just some plain old white socks. Get your little onesie. Baby handy. His little mittens. And then some little pants with his initials. Second little outfit, which I don't even know like what outfit I'm gonna have him take his pictures in. I don't know what outfit I'm gonna have him going home in. So that's why, and that's another reason why I have like more than one option, because I just don't know. So these, got some little pants, baby handy. I just love the custom stuff. And these were gifted by his cousin. And then this onesie says, I got my good looks from my Uncle TT. And his Uncle TT is no longer with us anymore. So I just thought that that was like really, really cute to put with those little joggers. And then of course, some little socks. These are actually gray and like navy blue. And then his little hat that just goes perfectly. All this stuff is like navy blue, gray, and white. And then the little mittens to match. If you can see that. The little mittens to match. It's really bright. Let's turn down these lights on. Okay, there we go. That's better. Then these little mittens to match. So. Alright, another thing I thought that was really cute. This was, we put it on our registry and somebody bought it. Well, my brother and his girlfriend bought it. It's this cute little swaddle and hat set. And it comes with like a little name card. So, here's a little hat. Isn't that so cute? And here's a little swaddle. It's just like a little cocoon. So you just put his whole little body in here. And then it comes with a little name card. It says, Hello, my name is. There's a gray side. And there's a blue side. And then in that size is a 0-to-3. The The first two ones I showed you were newborn, and then that is 0 to 3, and then this last little outfit is 0 to 3 too. So nothing too crazy about this one. It's just an extra outfit to have if you can't fit his newborn stuff. So just some socks, little mittens that adds like the moon and stuff on it. His little hat, some nice little pants, and his little onesie that says "Be a little wild." Also, something else that I put in his diaper bag is some Vaseline. Reason I put Vaseline in here is because I know that he's gonna be getting circumcised while at the hospital. I don't wanna hear nobody saying nothing about why are you getting your son circumcised? It ain't your business. Just know that I'm taking this to ease, you know, put a barrier between the diaper and his little wee wee. And also, we put some baby Dove in the bag, because like I said, if they try to use some Johnson & Johnson on our son, no, we got our own soap. I was debating on even bringing lotion, just because like, he's not getting like a full bath, he's getting like a sponge bath, like a rinse off. And I know his skin is gonna be, you know, start peeling and stuff. So if I do decide to put some lotion in there, it's gonna be like the same brand, Baby Dove. And then last but not least, in this little case right here is his pacifier. I know they give him a pacifier at the hospital, but I'd rather try to have him use this pacifier because this is the one I kind of want him to use, like, from now until whatever, you know, if he even takes pacifiers, you know. So that's it for Junior's bag. Okay, now moving on to Mommy's bag. Mommy has a suitcase. I just feel like it would be easier to just roll a bag in there versus, you know, carrying a bag in there. I don't want my fiance to have to carry all those bags. He can roll, at least roll one, you know. Anywho, so I packed a blanket so I can be like more comfortable and feel like more at home. Here's my blanket. Here's just an extra empty bag to take all the stuff that's in the hospital room to bring it home, like extra diapers, wipes, like whatever they give me as far as like postpartum care. I'm putting all that crap in his bag, because you know why? All they do after you leave, if you don't take none of that stuff, all they do is throw it away. So I mean, they already charged your arm and leg in hospital just for birthing your child, but whatever, that's another story for another day. So just take everything, okay? Empty bag for that reason. All right. Let's go ahead and dig through my toiletries. So they're just in this little bag here. None fancy, none special. I have some Dove soap. Okay. Have some lotion. Some deodorant. Some face wash, some Cetaphil face wash and Cetaphil moisturizer. I have some like cleansing towelettes, like little face wipes. got some good old Listerine. Toothbrushes for me and my fiance, and some toothpaste. And I also have some nipple cream for breastfeeding purposes. I'm not sure if I'm gonna need it, but I just packed it just in case. This is the Boob Ease Organic Nipple Balm. This is what it looks like. I got it from Target. Not sure how much it was. I bought it, but yeah. All right, got some shower shoes. My aunt came in clutch. She got me like this whole like hospital slash postpartum kit. It had some coochie pops in there. If you don't know what coochie pops are for postpartum use. So it's just a pad with like witch hazel in it. Oh, excuse me. It's just a pad with witch hazel in it and like pure aloe vera gel. So that's all the coochie pop is. And they're in the freezer waiting for my postpartum days. All right. I got some scrunchies to like put my hair up. Yeah, let's get into these twists, honey. DIY Marley twist, honey. Did these myself. Also got a little speaker, you know, to listen to some music. I just want to feel as comfortable as possible, like at home as possible. You know, I just want everything to be a vibe. Like I'm really not even that nervous about like the whole birthing thing. I'm kind of excited because I'm really ready to meet my son. But yeah, we're gonna need some music to listen to, so when I'm up and moving around, you know, pushing through these surges, it'll be a little better. Cause I don't plan on getting an epidural. Okay. I have a diffuser for like my essential oil. So I have peppermint oil in here, and it's just gonna help me, you know, relax and things like that. And help like with any nausea I might have or anything like that during the labor process. I have a fan to clip on the bed because I know I'm gonna be hot. I just know it. I've been hot my whole pregnancy. So here's my little fan. All right. Also, I packed 2 nursing bras. Here's what they look like. They had padding in them, but I am not a big fan of padding in bras. I'm just not. So I have this one, and this actually came, yeah, this actually came in a 4-pack, volume pack 2. So it's like this nice little cream looking one, this burgundy one, then there's like a dark green one, and then there's a black one. But the nursing bras, all it does is just like snaps, it unhooks and it hooks down, and then you can snap it back. Got these off of Amazon. 4-pack for like $25. It's not bad at all. I got these big old granny panties. These big old granny panties, okay. Also have them in black. Also I know they're gonna provide one at the hospital, the little Perry bottle to like rinse you off down there when you go tinkle. But the one in the hospital is just like a regular, just like a regular bottle. My aunt got me this one, so that way I don't have to like struggle to like get the right angle to hit the right spot. I can just turn it upside down and so yeah, that's this. This is the brand, if y'all are wondering. But I know a lot of moms get like the Frida Perry bottle. But if you're looking into other options and another brand, here's one. Okay. All right. On to clothing. So went to Walmart, got this little gown. It says cute but crazy but cute. Don't really care about the wording. I just want to be comfortable, and these are really comfortable. It was only like $7 at Walmart. My aunt also gifted this to me as well. And it's like this gown, this little nightgown that has buttons in the front of it. It's kind of like a robe too because it ties. I think this is like perfect as far as me having to do skin to skin, breastfeeding, and that good stuff. And it's really, 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 really soft. I like it. I like soft stuff. I got some fuzzy socks with the grips at the bottom. These are really, really comfortable. That's one pair. Then I also have another pair. These with little grips at the bottom. And as far as what I'm going home in, nothing fancy. I just have two things to choose from. I have some plain old black maternity tights, because as you all may know, even though the baby will be here, I will still look at least 6 months, 7 months pregnant. So these are maternity tights. And just a plain like shirt. Or I have these little leggings and just a regular striped shirt. Nothing special. Just going home. Have some lip chap. You don't want to have no dry lips during labor, okay? You don't want to have no dry lips. And I also packed some nipple pads just in case. I mean, I don't think I'm gonna need them, but I packed them just in case. You know, milk supply comes in a little early. Whatever, because my colostrum came in, even though I know it produces early, I didn't think I was gonna like actually like see it come out. It started coming out at like 26 weeks pregnant, so I was like, oh okay, you ready. So also we packed a like a little power strip, just to have some extra, you know, outlets, because they don't be having the outlets in them rooms. Kind of like a cruise ship. You ever been on a cruise? They only have like them two outlets on the wall. Yeah, anybody got time for that? My aunt also gifted me these medicated pads, like for down there to like help soothe, you know, what's going on down there after birth. So yeah, I packed that as well. And also some Dermaplast to spray down there as well for like discomfort or whatever. A lot of moms swear by this. Hopefully they give me some at the hospital too. I'm gonna take all that. Yeah. So that's it for mommy's bag. Where's daddy's bag? You don't want me to show them what's in daddy's bag? It's just clothes. Okay. Anywho, you know, the daddies don't need much, okay? All he has in there is a couple outfits, blanket, pillow. I'm also gonna bring one of my pillows for myself, you know, just to be more comfortable. Also, I know some people like to bring like their own towels. I know Kobe, my fiance, has, he's gonna have his own like bath towel dry phone and everything. I'm personally not gonna do that because I know there's gonna be a lot of blood and I don't want that on my stuff. Before I forget, last thing but not least, we got a snack bag. Okay.
Snack.
That's how you feel?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Anywho, please do not mind my fiance. He's a little extra sometimes, okay? This is mommy's chip bag. I love these things. Okay. Love them, love them, love them. Nine times out of ten, pretty sure all this not gonna get ate, but you know, you can never be too prepared. I just wanted to have some stuff for, you know, him and I to snack on. But yeah, I already dipped into my applesauce and got some unsweetened applesauce. Dang, I didn't even realize you packed all this. Okay. My business. This his bag. Clearly this whole snack bag belong to him. Anywho, he got some bugles. I don't even eat those. Some individual bugle chip bags and some fruit snacks. Got some Chips Ahoy chunky white fudge chocolate chip cookies. I know y'all probably looking like, oh my God, where's the healthy snacks? He is bringing his own water bottle. I'm not gonna bring one because they're gonna provide me one at the hospital. So, this is his. And we also have some Crayon tropical juice. It's really good, by the way. And he packed himself two orange sodas.
Who love orange soda?
Apparently you love orange soda.
Yes, sir.
But that's it. That's all we're taking to the hospital. Nothing, like I said, nothing special is in his bag. He just has clothes and whatever else in there. But yeah. Oh. Only thing that I forgot that's not in my bag that I haven't mentioned, that I did mention, was like phone chargers, all that. I mean, but I just feel like that's low-key common sense. whenever the time comes, like, it'll be packed. I'm currently not working. I've been put on bed rest, so I won't forget to put that in the car once that time comes, because I'm just in the house until I go into labor. So I am in the house until I go into labor, so none of that stuff will be forgotten. So it'll be any day now. He'll be here any day now. Super excited. I also need to show you guys our shared bedroom / nursery. Might do that in a minute, but or maybe later. Share bedroom / nursery. We're in a one bedroom apartment. We were gonna move, but honestly, I didn't feel like moving. And he, like, Junior doesn't need his own room right now at the moment anyway. So everything's all good. There's enough space for all three of us. So until next time, bye guys.